why do we love music? Everybody's got their own reasons. But from an evolutionary perspective, our love of music doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It didn't contribute to our survival or help our ancestors make babies. It turns out that the key to your musical feels might be chemistry. A 2011 study from Valorie, Salimpoor, and others looked at a group of people who reliably got musical chills, then asked them to make a playlist of their favorite songs of any style. These people listened to the tracks while scientists monitored their brain activity. They found that music triggers the release of a chemical called dopamine in a part of the brain called the striatum. Evolutionarily, this is a really old part of the brain, associated with responses to stuff that make you feel good. This showed that listening to, say, Daft Punk, affects the same areas of the brain as chocolate, sex, or cocaine. It was the first time somebody revealed that an abstract reward like listening to music could release dopamine, as opposed to a tangible reward like a delicious burrito. It might also explain why people love paintings or other forms of art. The study gives us a clue about why tension and release is so important in music. Let's use what dance music fans call the drop as an example. It's that amazing moment when the audience is locked in with the artist. Then all of a sudden, the beat drops out. All that's left is a melody. Then another element creeps in, then another, building tension. Your pupils dilate, your heart rate goes up. Everybody in the audience knows it's coming. The drop. From the Isley Brothers shout to a huge EDM drop, the tension and release in these songs make for some incredible musical moments. The study hints at why they feel so good. We'll let Vanessa from BrainCraft explain.
We associate surges of dopamine with pleasure, with the processing of actual rewards. And the listeners had more dopamine release in their brains during their favorite parts. But surprisingly, there was also increased amount of dopamine in a slightly different part of the brain before the listener got to their favorite part of the song. The authors called this the anticipatory phase of listening, where our brains help us predict the arrival of our favorite part. Neuroscientists believe this region of the brain is involved in creating learned responses to stimuli. In this case, a change in a song's beat or melody can be a cue that a reward is coming. The same way Pavlov's dogs started drooling when they heard a buzzer, a dancer's brain starts releasing dopamine during the breakdown of a song, knowing that a musical rush is coming soon.
A great band or DJ can really get dopamine levels rising in these moments. The drop can be delayed or manipulated to heighten the musical climax. And the great thing about this work is that it extends to all genres. Music is subjective. You can get your dopamine rush from a house music buildup or classical music. It may even explain why fish heads love a 4-hour jam band set, even if we still don't get it. Huge thanks to Vanessa from BrainCraft for dropping by. We're big fans of her channel. You should go check out her newest video on audio illusions, and while you're there, definitely subscribe to her channel for more great videos on all things brain-related. And for more on dopamine, check out this video that explains how Adderall works. Like this week's video? Make it official and hit that like button, and subscribe to get new episodes every week. Have a burning chemistry question? Let us know in the comments, and we'll try to answer it in a future video. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.